Today, we're talking about unemployment rates and labor market again. Our goal is to talk about trends in the labor market, and then we'll finish off this discussion of unemployment by talking about shortcomings of the unemployment rate or the U3 rate that is often discussed in the news. When we look at labor markets, it's important for us to evaluate unemployment rates and labor market outcomes by demographics and subgroups. As economists and researchers, we are interested in variations and outcomes based on the subgroups that we have in the economy. And we're also interested in seeing how policy impacts those outcomes. We're looking at the overall labor force participation rate in the US since 1960. What we see is the labor force participation rate starts at 59% in 1960, and over the next 40 years, it continues to grow, reaching a high of 67% in 1990 and 2000. Since then, however, the labor force participation rate has been declining. When it comes to labor force participation rate, the more interesting comparison is between the labor force participation rate for men and women. Over that same period, women's participation rate has increased from 38% to 57%, while men's labor force participation rate has fallen from 83% in 1960 to 69% in 2019. Comparing men and women's unemployment rate, we do not see much of a difference. Men's unemployment rate is slightly higher at times, but not consistent enough for us to establish a pattern. The more extreme comparison, and it's something economists are spending a lot of time trying to understand, is the difference between the white and black unemployment rates. In 1988, the black unemployment rate was more than double the white unemployment rate. The racial gap has narrowed since. However, in 2020, the gap increased again. The COVID-19 recession caused an increase in overall unemployment. However, the recession impacted Blacks and African Americans at higher rates. It is important for us to examine labor market trends. However, what we've discussed in previous videos is that it's important for us to know what data to use. The unemployment rate that is often reported in the news is the U3 unemployment rate. However, we know that the BLS reports the U1 through the U6. And also, it reports all of these unemployments by subcategories. If we rely entirely on the U3 unemployment rate, we will not get an overall understanding of the labor market. The U3 unemployment rate has some shortcomings that we'll discuss. First, it does not make it clear who is and is not unemployed. We need more granular data to make the comparisons helpful. The U3 also neglects to account for discouraged workers. If discouraged workers are not included as unemployed, then it is possible for unemployment rate to fall when people give up looking for a job. Not because they found a job, but because they gave up looking for a job. Therefore, following just the U3 will be misleading. Also, the U3 does not tell us about underemployment. As we enter a recession, high-skilled workers might shift from high-paying jobs to lower-paying jobs. While they are now underemployed, the unemployment rate won't reflect that. Unemployment and labor markets are important vital signs of the economy. Understanding what is happening in labor markets allows us to make better decisions as we navigate changes in the economy. It is also important to know which data to use and its strengths and weaknesses. And now we have a better idea of what's happening in labor market trends and some of the shortcomings with the unemployment rate.